4 steps were to be taken in the correct order.
Thank you.
to find an enemy not attacking, and also already destroyed, was unknown to the Bergson. Was this enemy of their enemy a friend? Much to the Bergson's surprise, the enemy of their enemy was only another small automaton. The same human grief clung to this little one as it did the one back home. Coincidence, it was not. Gears continued to crank on in the distance, for the city must survive. Now, even more soulless than before, without life, and as if none had ever existed within the gears, and a new road forward opened with the jewel of life. The Berksons stood at the gates of Anai Saravar, but caution dictated going back and informing the others. Were they cursed? The more they moved ahead, the more the corruption came forth. Blocked from light, everything with us. The Berksons wondered what dangers could lie ahead still. The two little automatons were surely connected. But another was yet to be found. The darkness threatened to overwhelm them, but they needed to unshackle the last spirit as soon as possible.
Thank you.
Adam finally finds someone to ask about the black substance. A chamber touched only by earth, wind, and the powers that be.
Thank you.
Their life giving way to new life, moving the cycle ever forward. The final little automaton. And the most in need of help. Inanimate, so still, as if time around him had frozen. Thank you. failing machine kept her on the brink, its corrupted power core leaving her poisoned and unable to pull herself back. He knew a replacement power core was required, but doubted his ability to survive the retrieval. Was a scientist, not a fighter. A stable power core was valuable and would be guarded. The Bergson understood the guard dogs needed to be put down. And did wonder that if the core was life, what were they doing to this machine? The theft would not go unnoticed, and more automatons will certainly come. Man worked. Waiting, the Bergson continued to contemplate. On whether a life so dependent on machines was even possible. In the Forgotten Room, a relic of power.
Thank you.
She flaunted her wings, begging to be chased. Do not linger. Deeper into the depths she moved. Further she fled. It was the end of the line for Bellagio. Ane Sarava, the architect of Terralava, and the creator of Jin, a machine meant to serve the land, not oppress it.
Thank you.
air became aggressive, the temperature rising as energy returned to the Mighty One and flowed through his veins. Anais Harava was free again. As the spirit gazed upon the family, he felt something different, something unusual. Perhaps this could indeed be the final cycle. The spirit's words took life, forming images to reveal what was hidden from the Bergsons. Excitement filled the empty space. The promise made was now a promise fulfilled. The rock appeared on the horizon, and the boundless wander ended. Journey had met destination. And the vagabond son of the heavens became the mountain god. His heart skipped, his mind echoed with music. His breath caught when the daughter of Rhea stole his heart. And carved it with her name, Rhea Dana. Two became a pair, mates joined in happiness. Who willed to elevate Rhea's creatures? From her wisdom, three spirits were created to guard the eons. And they lived 1,000 years in bliss. Until Rhea Dana bore him a daughter. The mountain god could not stand her as he envied the child. Furious, he raged at Rhea Dana. And she left him. He wore the grudge as if it were a crown, one made of corruption. Cursing the name of Rhea Dana's daughter, he descended into resentment. Thus was the truth revealed to the Bergsons, and the origin of the corruption. Uncle Ben repaired his body, but it was their presence that brought him back. Thank you. They were built as a family, and a family they shall stay. Pity or anger, the Bergsons stood shocked, not knowing how to react to the story. The important thing, however, was to break the cycle of evil. But they still did not know what awaited the children of Morta in the temple of the mountain god. Their final destination was on the other side of that gate. The ending was nigh. mountain god U himself. Without Rhea Dane's love, the darkness still inside him, consuming and uncontainable. And without Rhea Dana's love, jealousy would swallow her children. Heavy as iron and difficult to breathe in, the air burned their lungs. It was pitch black. The light meant protection and hope. And the Bergson had to rescue the others as well. Of another light. Two more Bergsons found, but they all were still in danger in the darkness. The rest of the family had to be saved. Yet another light, fending off the darkness, for now. Time was short, and haste was needed. The final battle was nearing its end. The Bergsons knew that this was the final step. Love must prevail over hatred.
Yeah.
The Supreme One. Master of all and master of nothing. His greatest fear was made absolute. He was left alone. Left alone to his misery and failure, to the unending cycle of despair and pain. He wished for its end, wished to bathe in an eternal darkness. Mercy prevailed as the wheel had turned back to kindness. That which was expelled from the heart returned. All the time apart melting away, along with all the pain, all the sadness, and all the misery. Land met sky, two became one. Love ignited rapture as innocence flooded the space between breaths. Happiness and curiosity weaved, mixed, and tangled in a dance a millennium in coming. As the One ascended, but will never leave, a family looked upon the mountain and land over which they were given ward. A family left exhausted was now more complete than before. A god once stricken with grief was now whole. And the land once cast into chaos was now left in serene balance. As the story comes to its conclusion, remember this. When the time spent in this land is looked back upon, when daring feats are recited along with victories and defeats, remember that it was not a tale of heroes or villains, nor of good and evil, but one of family, and above all else, a tale of love. Go now, Guardian, and never forget. Never before had the Bergsons seen, nor had they heard, such a vast trove of myth and legends. They were so mesmerized by Apon's storytelling that they spent the whole night transfixed as her audience.